Welcome to Narc Abuse No More, where we're here to help educate you about narcissistic abuse, because your feelings do matter. Hi, and welcome to another podcast of Narc Abuse No More with your host, Dr. and Evangelist, K.O. Rich. Thanks for tuning in today. Today is Monday. Oh my goodness, it is Friday. It is Friday. No, it is not Monday. Praise the Lord. We get a weekend. Again, my name is Dr. K.O. Rich with Narc Abuse No More, where we're here to help you admit what you feel in order to heal from the effects of narcissistic abuse, because your feelings do matter. Yes, they do. But before we go on with today's podcast, I'd like to invite you to visit us on our website at www.narcabusenomore.org. Again, that website address is www.narcabusenomore.org. And on our website, you'll find valuable information regarding narcissism, relationships. And if you have missed any of these podcasts, all you have to do is go directly to our website and listen to us from there. Now, just to let you know, we are on every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 9 a.m. Central, and that is on SoundCloud, iHeartRadio, Spotify, Spreaker, Google Play, iTunes, CastBox, and Deezer. We're also on Amazon Audible, Rumble, Brighteon, and The Tube. That's right, we are on YouTube. So you have a variety of different platforms to listen to us from. But if all else fails, all you have to do is go directly to our website again at www.narcabusenomore.org. Also, just to let you know, for those who are my SoundCloud audience, you might want to also subscribe to my YouTube channel. Again, that's Narcissistic Abuse No More. You'll still see that the picture icon on there that you see on SoundCloud, just so you'll be able to know which one you're subscribing to, because sometimes we're not able to put up. We don't have all the previous podcasts on that one because it's the free version. However, if you want to have more access to various podcasts that you may have missed, you can subscribe to the YouTube channel or go directly to the website and listen to us from there. All right, what are we talking about today? We are talking about how to heal from emotional abuse. How to heal from emotional abuse. So many people have been abused emotionally, and they are carrying around weights. They're carrying around bags. They're carrying around tons of weights on them that is from the emotional abuse that they've experienced. And so they carry it into other relationships. They carry it on the job. They will carry it with them in their churches. They carry it with them everywhere. And speaking of weights, I want to just let you know that I am in the process of updating my book, The Weight of Weights. That will be re-released either by the end of this month or the first part of June. And it's called The Weight of Weights. I will let you know when it's available on Amazon.com, Barnes & Noble, Lulu.com, and other platforms. This book deals with the different types of weights that we carry. And one of them is emotional weights that from past hurts, past traumas. And the only way to be able to be free from those weights is you have to release them. It's just like if you can't go up Mount Everest. For those who have maybe heard of people who have climbed Mount Everest, or if you have been one to go hiking, and you know that, hey, I can't take everything with me, because the more weights that I'm carrying, the more burdensome it's going to be. And so as I'm climbing up, it's going to get really difficult for me to maintain my own weight as well as carrying extra weights. And that's what people are often doing in life. They are carrying additional weights. And until you free yourself from those weights, you're going to be bowed down when it comes to being in relationships, because your relationship will not be able to thrive and move forward in the positive sense if you're carrying waste. Many people that are even abusers, the reason they are abusers, and this is not to make an excuse for anyone who is an abuser, because you can get the help that you need. But many people who are the aggressive ones, the abusers, they are often carrying weights from someone who may have did the exact same thing to them. So, but instead of them changing, instead of them seeking help, they went and started doing it to someone else. And that is inexcusable there, because we all have choices. So again, the book is called The Weight of Weights. And I'm going to keep you updated as to whenever that book comes back out, the second edition. And I'm going to have a chapter in there that's dedicated to narcissism, But it's also going to deal with other things, for as procrastination and other types of things that's in there, for as weights that people carry. All right, so today we're talking about emotional abuse, healing from emotional abuse. And emotional abuse, it actually impacts people in various ways. Abuse can occur in the childhood. If you suffered abuse during childhood, it could be from relationships with others, such as coworkers, family, friends. It can also be romantic relationships. Many people are carrying around emotional abuse, or are actually going through it right now, emotional abuse, because you're in a relationship with someone who does not respect or love you. And let me just say this, love, people, is an action word. Love is an action word. That means that when you love someone, you're going to show them that you love them. All right? And it's not good enough to say, oh, I love you, but then you're hurting me. You could say, I love you, but then you putting a knife into my leg, so therefore you're causing me pain. But you're saying verbally, oh, I love you, but then you're sticking this knife and you're twisting it in my leg. That is not love. And so many people are experiencing that on the emotional level, that someone is saying to them, I love you, but you're lying to me. I love you, but you're cheating on me. I love you, but you're beating me. I love you, but you're not loyal to me. I love you, but I can't trust you. I love you. And love it begins to lose the essence of what it should be. So today we're talking about this emotional abuse, and often it comes from people that claim to love you, or at least they're supposed to love you, and it can leave a scar and it can leave you damaged. And you're saying, you know what, I feel like I don't know how to move forward. I don't know what to do. And so therefore you're having a hard time in life because of the emotional trauma, the emotional abuse that you have gone through. And so there are things that can cause damage, and you might say, well, why is it I can't succeed in life? Why is it I'm not reaching my dreams? Why is it I'm not making better choices? Why do I keep picking these same type of individuals? And one of the reasons is you might blame yourself. You might have shame about what you have gone through, because oftentimes people that have been emotionally abused, they tend to doubt themselves. They tend to blame themselves. They tend to be shamed because of what took place to them. For example, someone that may have been molested as a child, they may carry around the shame that, oh, I was molested, and so therefore I'm damaged goods, and no one's going to love me, and no one's going to value me, no one's going to appreciate me, no one's going to see me for who I am, because after all, I'm damaged goods. And they may have been made to feel that way because of what the abuser said to them, what the abuser did to them. They might say, well, why didn't I tell someone? But then you often may not even realize that the abuser has so much control and power that they made you fear going to tell anyone, because you would suffer the consequences of their wrath. And so therefore you decided to keep it hidden and bottled up inside, because after all, no one's going to believe me. And often oftentimes people will stay in an abusive relationship because they feel as if no one is going to believe them. No one is going to receive them. No one is going to see that it's not me, it's them. But because the narcissist is so charming, because the abuser is so likable, that people, you might say, well, they won't believe me. And so oftentimes people will carry around this self-doubt, this shame, this blame, and it causes them to have low self-esteem. It causes them to feel as if they are incapable of making decisions. It causes them to have doubt about themselves. It causes them to feel as if no one's going to love them. And let me just say this, because you will often hear an abuser say, no one's going to love you like I do. And please tell me that's a prophecy, because I don't want anyone to so-called love me like you're loving me if you are an emotional abuser. Another thing that when you're dealing with emotional abuse, you might have you might be socially isolated. Abusers, they will use tactics to try to isolate their victims away from friends, away from family, away from coworkers, away from people who they know would love the target of their abuse. Why? Because they don't want anyone to actually let that victim know that, hey, you don't have to go through this. You don't have to keep dealing with this. They don't want anyone to see through them. A narcissist, one thing that a narcissist will try to do is they will put on a charm, they wear a facade, they have a mask, and where other people may not see what's going on, the narcissist is concerned about their image. If all else fails, they want their image to be in place, because after all, they don't want people to see the real deal. They don't want them to see the bloodsuckers that they are, okay? Narcissists are like leeches. They are emotional vampires. They will suck the life out of their victim. So therefore, they will put you in social isolation. You might go somewhere and they will start an argument. Oh, well, you shouldn't be around this one. You shouldn't be around that one. They want to make you feel as if you don't deserve to have friends. You don't deserve to have people that love you. You don't deserve to have a social life. They want you socially isolated. And this is a form of control over the individual and the relationship. So you might sometimes see, you know, someone that's a victim of abuse, whether it's physical, emotional, sexual, spiritual, whatever the case may be, and they will make you feel, speaking of the abuser, they will make that person feel as if they've committed the greatest sin. They have blasphemed against God if they have some people in their life that love them. And what it is, it's a form of manipulation and control to keep that person from knowing that they don't have to deal with the type of abuse. Anyone who calls the abuser out immediately becomes an enemy of the abuser. Those who have dealt with emotional abuse, one of the effects is it affects your mental health, your physical health. And when you are in a type of long-term relationship with someone that is abusive, it could cause you to experience an array of emotions such as panic, such as worry, such as anxiety, such as depression. It will cause you to, some people have ulcers because they have been so worried and stressed out. Your body tends to react. Your heart might start palpitating just with the person pulling up in the driveway. And it takes a toll over you. Some people, they will go into binge eating because of the stress that they're up under with an emotional abuser. Some may do just the opposite and become anorexic or even bulimic or whatever because of the stress that they're dealing with when it comes to an emotional abuser. It takes its toll on you physically. And even in addition to those who are going through the physical abuse, that person is kicking, punching, biting, spitting at you, doing all kinds of things. It takes its toll. Another effect when you're talking about emotional abuse is it can damage your relationships with others. You might struggle with being in relationships with others because you're still bound by the things that took place with you in a previous relationship. And so you might have trust issues to say, I can't trust people now because the person that I did trust, they wind up abusing me. So therefore, you might isolate yourself from other people. You might have a hard time forming connections with other people. You might have times being in trusting a healthy relationship with others because in the back of your mind, you're thinking that at some point, this is going to fail just like the last one did. The person I trusted the last time broke my heart and was emotionally abusive to me. And this time, I don't want to fall for the okie doke again. I don't want to fall for the person because they may do the same thing. So therefore, you might have a hard time forming relationships with other people. We're going to take a quick break and we'll be back in just a moment.
Took some time to come around. You down. A bit too late for sorry now. My pride got in the way. Yes, it did.
You're the one,
and all I need is you.
Yvonne and Brian McKnight and Joe coming back home. All right, so we're still talking about emotional abuse and healing, tips for us healing from emotional abuse. So we just went over the effects of emotional abuse. And when you are trying to go through recovery, there's a lot of different types of emotions, just different things that you will experience in order to heal, or when you're in a healing process. Before we go on with today's podcast, I'd like to give you a website where you can get this valuable information, www.talkspace.com, www.talkspace.com. Sometimes you have a hard time expressing your emotions or your feelings because when you have been with an abuser, they have caused you to feel as if you have to suppress those feelings. You have to suppress those emotions. And that's why we talk about on this podcast that your feelings do matter. You have maybe buried them because the abuser, the toxic individual, the narcissist has made you feel as if, oh, well, I have to suppress my feelings for the sake of theirs. This comes into those that are often the people pleasers, where you feel like I have to please this one and please that one. If I don't please them, then, you know, they're not going to love me. They're not going to be happy with me. So therefore, I have to bury my feelings, bury my emotions in order to make this other person feel happy. You might even struggle to make decisions because that abuser has taken the power away from you to make you feel as if you're capable of operating independent of them. And that's another form of emotional abuse. And so therefore, you're having a hard time maybe getting back on track to understanding what you want in life and independent of that abuser. But there is help. You don't have to keep being abused. You don't have to keep going through the pain and the trauma of the past. You can heal from emotional abuse, and you will find that you are that much better emotionally, psychologically, socially when you are working on the healing aspect of it. And so we're going to talk about today for us tips for healing from abuse. Number one of the things that is so important to do is to recognize the abuse. You don't want to make excuses for the person who abused you. We don't want to be trauma bonding. We don't want to have that Stockholm syndrome. We want to acknowledge that this actually did happen. The abuser, the narcissist, whomever, will sometimes gaslight you to make you doubt your reality, to make you think, oh, it wasn't what you said, or it didn't happen the way you said, or it was all in your head, or no one else would think that way. But recognize the abuse. You have to know your truth of what happened to you. And this is part of the process. This is the part of coping and dealing and being honest about it. You have to be honest about it and say, this is what happened to me. And when you start understanding what you went through, then you will be able to form healthy relationships because you'll be able to better connect with others. This is why we always talk about on this podcast what abuse is, so that you will recognize it. Is it normal for people to be abusive? No, that is not the norm. It is not normal when you're in a relationship with someone, you're married to someone, it is not normal for them to cheat. Okay, that is not normal. We have to get out of in society when we say, oh, this is normal behavior. We celebrate normal behavior. No, it's not normal. It is normal to be faithful. All right. It is normal to be loving. It is normal to be caring. It is normal for me not to want to accept your abuse. That's what's normal. And so we can make a ton of excuses as to, oh, they had a bad childhood, they had a hard upbringing, they didn't have a mother, they didn't have a father, blah, blah, blah. And yes, those things do come into effect when it comes to the person that is actually doing the harm to say, you know what, this is why I am like this. But at the same time, I have to take accountability for my actions and deal with them so that I can change. So, in other words, we're saying, learn to recognize emotional abuse. That means that when I know what I'm dealing with, this, when we talk on this podcast about knowing the signs of narcissism and knowing the terminology when it comes to narcissism, so that you'll know when someone is gaslighting you, when you'll know when someone's triangulating you, when you will know when someone is stonewalling you, you will know when someone is trying to manipulate, all the different things. We talk about these things so that you will recognize it. And the only way not to play the game of the narcissist is to know the rules to the game, so that you would know how not to operate. So we're going to go to the next one, is remember that it was not your fault. Oftentimes, abusers will make you feel like it's your fault that they abused you. I've seen where, for example, children who were molested, and the mothers who did not want to leave their boyfriends and husbands that actually did it, they will make the children, that maybe that daughter, feel like, oh, if you had not worn this, or if you had not done this, or it's your fault that they wanted you and wanted to molest you and you were the child. So remember that it is not your fault. Don't blame yourself. You might say, well, it's my fault. You're listening to those words that were spoken over you, and they're running around in your head like a movie marathon. Remember, it is not your fault. That abuser made the choice to abuse. And you are not the one that should blame yourself for the abuse. Remember, that person was the one that abused you. However, you're now at a place where you can make a decision to no longer take the abuse. There is help. You can get the help that you need, and you do not have to feel like you have to stay entangled with that abuser. Number three, document your feelings. Sometimes you may have a hard time expressing what you feel, especially if you go to counseling. You might, you know, have a hard time really talking about things. So one of the ways to actually start facing and dealing with the emotional abuse that you have experienced is to document, put down what you feel. You know, if you have low self-esteem, say you have low self-esteem. If you have doubt about yourself, well, say that I have doubt about myself. I don't know why, but I have doubt about myself, because that will help you come to terms with whatever's going on in your life, or whatever you have experienced, or whatever the abuse you have experienced. So make a journal, document your feelings. If something happens and you say, you know, I'm feeling a certain way because this person just did this to me, document it so that you can become aware of your feelings and be in touch with your feelings. Again, one of the things that abusers often try to do is to make you feel as if you don't have a right to have feelings, but you do. Another thing is focus on your needs. When you're in a toxic relationship, you may have ignored your needs, your wants, your desires, because you were focused on that abuser. And that abuser made you feel as if only their feelings matter and yours didn't. So it's time, when you're in that healing process, to focus on your emotional needs, your physical needs, your spiritual needs. There's nothing wrong with focusing on you. This is not being selfish. This is saying, you know what, I have to focus and pay attention to me, because I can only be my best at helping others if I focus on my own needs. This means that if you feel like I need some rest, then get that rest. Or, I want to go and do something that's going to make me feel good, whether it's taking an art class, going back to school, or whatever the case may be. Do something for you. When you have gotten out of an abusive relationship, you have formed a pattern that may have put everyone else ahead of yourself, and you've been in the back burner. Now, sometimes when you're in a healthy relationship, you might do those things not because of an abusive situation, but because the dynamics of things require that at that particular time. But when you're in a healthy relationship, no one is going to want to always be a taker, okay? Both parties should want to give equally to that relationship. So, but when you're in an unhealthy, toxic relationship, you're always giving, the other person is always taking. So now it's time to focus on what you need. Next, it's important to create a support system. Abusers often isolate you from your friends, from your family, your coworkers, associates. They will isolate you and make you feel as if you don't need anyone else but them, because at the end of the day, they want to have power and control over you. So when you are working on your emotional health, hopefully apart from that person who has been abusing you, then it's time to reestablish those relationships if possible, to rebuild those relationships. And some people may not understand what you were going through, and so therefore they might feel as if you separated from them just because of your own doing. And if you feel that this is maybe something that a person was thinking, you may want to help them to understand what may have been going on, so that they will know it wasn't a call that you wanted to make. It was something that was forced upon you at that time. I remember that I had a friend, and her husband was abusive to her. And so whenever he would be around, she would like go into this shell where she wouldn't hardly say anything. But then, as you know, when he wasn't around, she was the social butterfly. She was outgoing and all funny, but she clammed up as soon as he was around. And you can really tell the difference in her demeanor when he was around. And so therefore, he did not want her to have friends. He was jealous. He was abusive, rather physically, emotionally, and eventually, you know, she left him after being with him for 10 years. But the thing is that you need that support system from others, and also a good support system helps you to not pivot backwards. Because sometimes people get out of the abusive relationship and then they wind up going back into it. And if you have a good support system, it can help to encourage you, to also help you if you're dealing with things like depression because of the relationship that you were in. I see so many people on social media platforms that have left these relationships finally, but then they're depressed because they are no longer with the person. So they start reminiscing on the good old days. And if the days were so good, you never would have had to leave to begin with. That's the thing to remember. You have selective memory sometimes when you're saying, oh, well, I'm alone, and maybe it wasn't as bad as I thought. And you start saying, well, he did do this, or she did do that, or whatever the case may be. But then you have that, what is it? I'm not going to say 80-20. You have the 90-10, where 90% of it was abusive, and then you're trying to hold on to that 10%. You have to be real with yourself and say it was not worth it. It is not worth it. Not to be someone's punching bag, whether physically, emotionally, spiritually, or any other way. We're going to take another quick break, and we'll be back in just a moment.
Yeah, this is for my brothers in the hood and the high rises, on the mansions with the maids. We got to come together, y'all. Come on.
out of here alone.
Well,
trying to face another day. Gotta stay strong. So endure this pain.
Talking about Forrest healing from emotional abuse, and one of the most important things when you're dealing with the healing, as we mentioned before, I want to just piggyback just a little bit, is creating a support system, which leads me to my next one, is to start therapy. If you are able to go to a counselor, I would recommend a good Christian counselor, but if you can go to a counselor, a support group or something of that nature for us, being able to help you with the long process that can sometimes be a little difficult because you start getting to various areas where you may have experienced different emotional setbacks in life. But support is very important, and therapy can help you to process things. It can help you to form coping strategies that are helpful, not destructive, but helpful coping strategies. And therapy can help you to get back on the right path. So if you are trying to heal from emotional abuse, and you might have feelings of hopelessness, you might be depressed, you might suffer anxiety. Some people may have PTSD, where you go back to that traumatic event that may have caused you to be experiencing emotional abuse. You can get help. There is help out there. You don't have to do this alone. Someone can help you to deal with it, help you to process, help you to walk through and get back on the right path. You don't have to feel like, hey, I'm going to be forever a victim. No, we want to be help you to be a survivor, not a victim, but a survivor. And so you can heal from emotional abuse. The first step, however, is up to you. And let me just say this before we go on with today's podcast. If you are in a life-threatening situation, or you are dealing with physical abuse, I want to give you information, and this is any type of abuse, information where you can get help. The website to the National Domestic Violence Hotline is www.thehotline.org. www.thehotline.org. You can also call 1-800-799-SAFE. That's 1-800-799-7233. TTY callers, 1-800-787-3224. You can also text the word START to 88788. Text the word START to 88788. And there is help out there. Again, you do not have to feel like you are having to deal with this or suffer alone. You can get help. Do not allow an abuser to make you feel like you're not to talk to anyone, or you have to continue in the abusive relationship. Get the help that you need. I also want to address those that are Christians that feel like, oh, because I'm a Christian, I have to stay in this abusive relationship. That is absolutely incorrect. Do not let any pastor, preacher, teacher, evangelist, whoever talk you into staying in an abusive relationship. Many will quote, oh, God hates abuse. Yes, he does hate abuse, and he also hates divorce. Let me just say this. So many people right now are dead because they did not leave the abusive relationship. They are 6 feet under, and do not think it can't happen to you. Just the other day, there was someone who, this man had killed 7 people. Most people will look at it from the aspect, oh, he was illegal. That wasn't supposed to be over here. It was more than just that. This man had actually, from what I understand, married a woman, and he wound up killing her, as well as, I believe it was her 3 children. So the grandmother actually lost 4 members of her family that day. And he also killed 3 others. People are snapping. Don't think that, oh, well, this person would never, because so many other people thought they would never, and they're dead today. This is serious. This is serious. Don't let anyone talk you into staying in an abusive relationship. All right, we are up out of here. I pray that today's podcast has been a blessing to you, and that you would know your feelings, they do matter. This is Again, this is Dr. K.O. Rich with Narc Abuse No More, helping you to admit what you feel in order to heal from the effects of narcissistic abuse. Until next time.